only reason I'd ever want to know why.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, otherwise, I don't care.
Yeah, I don't know how to change a tire.
I don't care.
I've watched people do it, but to say, okay, let me try it, no.
Oh, I can change a tire, and I can jumpstart a car.
Yeah.
I can even take the battery out if I needed to and bring it in and get a new battery.
Yeah.
And probably hook it up. But that's about as far as I could go with anything else. And I'd probably either watch a couple of YouTube videos or I'd call my brother who could just come and do it. Otherwise, why? Why do I care?
I know. It's just, it's more to add to, you know, the bank of knowledge. It's like, for what? You're listening to the show. My name is Elizabeth Mesa, and I'm here with Marie. Say your social media again.
Oh, yeah. Twitter, Marie_Lanza. I'm on Instagram, Marie_Lanza, and my website, marielanza.com. Yeah.
And they could find your books there and also on everywhere, like
everywhere.
Amazon, everything.
Amazon, Barnes & Noble, it's everywhere.
Yeah.
Gotta move. You gotta move. She made that back move. Damn. She made the titties move. God damn. I made the city move. Like, whoa. Thanks. I made the city move.
Cause I guess he can't.
I got the moves. I'm making moves. I got the moves.
I got the moves.
I'm making moves.
I'm making moves.
You gotta move.
You gotta.
She made that back move.
Damn.
She made the titties move.
God damn.
I made the city move.
I do.
I made the city move.
I do.
Look, give me the ball and I won't have to pass it. I ain't passing out till I'm asthmatic. I take a play and then I back to back and hit after hit, check the batting average. Check. I take the work, flip it acrobatic. Got a little time and a lot of talent. Do a little talking and a lot of action. Seen a competition, not a challenge. I lean, I move, I walk doing this bitch. Packed out, but I can count on my hands. So I'ma talk to in this bitch. Girls from law school in this bitch. Yeah, they paralegals. Barely 21, that's very legal. But they doing shit that's probably barely legal. Oh man, it's that nigga that you probably least suspected. I just had a couple dots. Need connected. Now your top five getting redirected. From here on out, it'll be consecutive. We making moves like Tarantino, like J.J. Abrams. Moving like Channing Tatum. Moving like Jason Statham. Motherfuck the whole industry. Half of these niggas my mini-me's. I got this bitch going off more than breaking the inner ring. You have for a mini-me. I make this shit that lasts for infinity. Hop in the booth and that shit like a Jiminy. Don't test the agility. Silly, silly thinking that the negativity you talking could ever fuck up the tranquility.
Okay, okay, okay. I'm on Rodeo for the day. If you owe me, then you better pay.
Okay, so would you rather?
Away, away, stay away. Or your ass might get KOK today.
Man, hit your ass like running like 28 days away.
I got the moves.
Okay, so how would I ask you, like, would you rather walk
I'm making moves.
Yeah, the zombies like the walking dead that can only walk around.
She made the titties move.
Damn.
I made the city move.
Like, whoa.
I made the city move.
That's right.
I got the moves.
I'm making moves.
I got the moves.
I got the moves.
I'm making moves.
I'm making moves.
You gotta move.
You gotta.
No, but that was a good audience.
She made the titties move.
God damn.
I made the city move.
That's a good one.
I made the city move.
Yeah, I do.
Look. I'm a Don, I'm a Don, I'm a Don. I gave my whole family jobs and I take care of my mom. Me and my girl been through so much, that's my partner in crime. Touch any of the above, now you harder to find. Gone.
You're listening to the show. My name is Elizabeth Mesa and I'm here with Marie Lanza. And during the break, Marie was trying to give me one of my would you rather. You know, I always ask would you rather questions. I think I'm just going to have you ask it, Marie.
How about
because
I ask you?
No. Well, because I don't know anything about like zombies
or monsters for that matter.
Yeah. So the first would you rather question is
would you rather, Elizabeth Mesa?
Yes.
Would you rather walking zombies or running zombies? Like walking, that's the fastest pace they can do? Or like 28 days later, you're running for your life at all times?
I would say walking.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
If the apocalypse happens and zombies are running around, we have no chance.
No.
None. None. It's the end. Just, you know, go with it.
What are like some of the other, like who else do you have? What other characters do you have that you can come up with a would you rather question?
All right. Would you rather vampires or werewolves? Would you rather?
Let's see. Probably werewolves because I don't like the biting the neck.
Come on.
No.
Vampires are so sexy and romantic. Of course you want to say vampire.
I'm like, I don't want the, you know, I remember when we used to watch the vampire movies, you know, what is it called? The Count Dracula?
Yeah. Oh.
I would always, like, I literally would have to like put my hands over my neck. Because I'm like, oh my gosh, like I can't see when they're like biting like the neck and stuff.
And clearly one of us has a thing for biting in this room.
Yes.
And one of us doesn't, so.
Is there anything that you've changed now that you're older that you're into that you weren't into then?
No.
Everything's the same?
If you've been listening us to radio for the last decade, nothing has changed.
Everything's still the same where you still have, do you still have like the treats and stuff?
Yeah. When we can. We have, you know, we do what we can.
Yeah. All right, let's see. Would you rather be hairy all over or completely bald?
Bald.
Yeah.
Completely bald.
Yes.
Wait, does that mean no hair on my head either?
Yes.
Yeah, I'd rather be completely bald.
Completely bald?
Yeah, I can put a wig on.
Would you rather be happy for 8 hours a day or poor or sad 8 hours a day and rich?
Wait, what?
Would you rather be happy for 8 hours a day and poor or sad for 8 hours a day and rich?
I like a more fulfilling life. I'd rather just be happy.
Yeah. Happiness is so much better.
It really is. We have one life.
You know what? Let me see. My other question that Alex gave me is, would you rather, what was that question about the orangutan? Would you rather have, Donald Trump's hair or look like an orangutan?
I'd rather look like an orangutan.
You're not a Donald Trump supporter, are you?
Please don't insult me. Please don't insult my intelligence. Okay. All right.
You know what's so funny is like whenever...
I can't believe you even had to ask that question.
I was like, well, let me ask just in case. But you know what? You're right. You wouldn't be. But
then
you never
know.
But you never know. It's like people change.
You know what?
Change.
That's true. And not just that. We, during this election, you and I had friends that shocked me, that supported this election,
like who?
This
Tell
administration.
Me like one person.
No, not out loud. No,
really?
Because then they would know that I'm insulted, but just by their votes. So
okay,
no.
So off air then.
I'll tell you
That's
off air.
Crazy.
There are people that shocked me.
You know what? I have to say, like the same thing for me. There's some people that shocked me when they came out of the woodwork, and I was like, "Wait, what?" I'm like, "You are," especially people that are Hispanics.
I think I think there are a couple of people in different kinds of people.
Yeah.
I think some people put their social issues aside and voted more conservative for more of a religious. That's a religious vote, more of like a conservative vote. And they were like, well, we can get by without this and we can get by without that. Not knowing that there was ultimate consequences.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying... This is not a party issue for me because I have voted on both sides many times.
Yeah.
And generally I'm a swing vote. This was more about the person.
Yeah.
It had nothing to do with the party. And I can't support, and there were a lot of people that supported the party just to support party.
Right.
And I can't do that. I'm definitely a complete independent. And I knew exactly, like there was no question.
Yeah.
There was no question.
And
I would not vote for that person.
I know. For me, it was the same thing. Would you rather eat poison ivy or a handful of bumblebees?
Ah. I would do the poison ivy over bumblebees.
I know.
Because you can die with too many stings, right? I've never heard of anyone dying by rolling around in poison ivy.
But what if you just, like start crunching like.
No.
Yeah. What if you just do like head first? Like, no, wait. Where's the sting is in the back.
Yeah, and the stinger would get your tongue. No.
But what if we take the stingers out and just like eat the actual?
No, because the stinger.
They're furry. Ugh.
No, I'd rather just roll around in poison ivy.
Would you rather be stranded on an island alone or with someone you hate? Is there people that you hate?
No.
No, right?
No. So I would rather do someone.
Oh, this is better. Would you rather be stranded on an island with Donald Trump?
Ugh, him again.
Or, not alone, because you're going to say alone. Or, oh my gosh. Or have zombies that are running coming at you.
Well, no, alone. Come on.
No, with Trump.
With him, I'd push him in front of him.
Would you rather be stranded in an island with Trump or be in the island stranded with running zombies?
Trump. He's old. Maybe he would like perish in some way, and then
he'll be like, you know how he does it? I was like, well, Marie.
You know what? With him, I could just go to the other side of the island, and I wouldn't have to put up with them. With running zombies, they would follow me.
But then with Trump, he would come over next to me and be like, but Marie.
He'd want to steal my land. No, I would. I would still pick him because I could go to the other side of the island.
Yeah. I guess the running zombies is just not.
No, there's no survival in beating that. Yeah. We're done. The world is over after that happens.
Would you rather have a third boob or like a bald chin, or like,
what
like
do you mean a bald chin? Oh, my chin, no, chin is bald.
Like balls on your chins.
You mean like double having, chins?
No, like they're actual balls.
Ew. Wait, what was the first option?
Would you rather have a third boob?
A third boob. Right now I could use one because I've got my kids still owning them. My husband still owns them.
Wait, she's still sucking it?
No, but she grabs onto it. She literally grabs onto them and says, and she's still very much, very possessive of them. So when they're out, like if I'm showering or something, Mama, my boob. No, honey, it's not yours.
That's funny.
It was once yours. But it's, and when she goes to bed at night, that hand goes right down my shirt. It's like a pervy old man at times. I'm like, really, baby? Really? They're mine. Let's talk about boundaries. These are my parts.
It's her comfort zone.
No, it is. It's a beautiful thing. But I love to tease about it because I'm like, well, you know, one day I'll own my own boobs again.
Yeah, you will.
One day. So I could use a third one right now.
That would be hers. Would you rather like not brush your teeth or not wear deodorant?
Deodorant. Yeah, I don't know. It's something about the taste in your mouth that... It's hard to get over. Yeah. But I would need to brush my teeth.
Yeah.
I was thinking, well, I could eat foods that covered that, but I don't think I'd, no, I'd want to brush.
All right,
my
last one is, would you rather smell like a fish or look like a blobfish? I'm like showing Marie the picture of the blob.
If I looked like a blobfish, would I still smell like one?
No, you would either look like it or smell like a fish. Yeah. And this would just, that would be your head, your face. You would have your normal body and that would be your face.
I'd rather smell like it.
I know. Can you imagine?
Yeah, because I could always.
That's so ugly. Ooh, what's that? Oh my gosh.
That is just awful.
I know. That's terrible, right? Can you believe this? Like, the show has come to an end. Like, that hour went by so quick.
It did. It was fun with you.
Yeah, that was so much fun. I'm so glad you came. And, of course, I'm going to ask you before we wrap, what type of underwear do you wear? You used to wear thongs before, didn't you?
Or commando.
Yes. What do you wear now?
Anything that's washed.
So you don't go commando anymore?
No.
What changed?
Pregnancy. I found that pregnancy changes a lot of things.
You know what? It's so true.
Yeah.
Okay, so what kind of underwear you wear, you said?
I wear whatever's washed. So if it's in my drawer and clean. No,
but
is it,
but are they like...
No, they're always cute.
Like boy shorts?
No, boy shorts I wear to bed.
So what do you...
So thongs to full coverage.
You don't wear like G-strings, right?
No.
Yeah, no, I don't like
those
either.
I said... Things are different down there. So I just wear like full, but like cute full.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
My husband like loves me to wear like superhero stuff. And he gets all like, oh, how cute you look. Cookie Monster, I think I wore yesterday. Like just real cutesy, like playful stuff these days.
You know what you should do? You should wear like the Wonder Woman outfit.
Oh, yeah. No.
Why not?
The outfits?
Just the
He would like that. He's into that.
You should wear like the cape And then like the underwear and like no, nothing on the boobs.
Oh, Lord. I can't even think of that.